How'd you feel after Kyrie did when you came back?
Yeah, I thought Kai was good. Just to get back into the flow of things, you know, sometimes there's a natural letdown when, you know, a player comes back from injury, and I thought the group, was going to now rely on Kai to kind of carry us, but give Utah credit, they came out and hit us in the jaw, and they were good tonight. We weren't.
Utah's like body movement off the ball and just closing plays on the weak side was a challenge. And same with the Memphis Warriors allowing 24 points off cuts. Is that an area that you would like to address heading into the homestand?
Yeah, you know, looking at Utah, they were at full speed. We were at half speed. So anytime that happens, you're not going to have any success. And then also, you know, we didn't shoot the three very well. So our energy was down, you know, for pretty much the whole game. It's a 7-point game, and we have an opportunity. We just couldn't get over the hump, and they ran away with it. But the cutting, the communication with our group was non-existent tonight. And as a coach, I take blame in that. You know, we got to be better.
You guys almost got whole again. I know Dante was questionable coming into the game.
Yeah.
But you got the lineup you finally got, and then.
Yeah, it's just he was hurt. He gave it a shot, and it just didn't make it. Unfortunately, that's just the nature of this business. You would like to be whole, but with his heel bruised, he tried, and he couldn't get get past it. So you can tip your hat for him trying, but unfortunately, we didn't get enough minutes with that group. I don't know.
It's the same injury listed as Kyrie's, but I guess there's different degrees of that.
Medically, I guess there's different degrees. I don't.
Okay.
I'm gonna stay out of that.
Okay.
Just one of those. Now you said you were kind of they were full speed. You were kind of half speed. It's just one of those nights where the energy wasn't there.
Yeah, we were flat. We tried everybody. When you look at getting someone back, the excitement. We just couldn't get in a rhythm. And I give Utah credit that the zone, the boxing one, the different defenses that they played tonight. We knew we were coming. We just didn't execute or capitalize on it tonight.
Feels longer.
Yeah.
I was excited to get back out there, man. It's a long time coming. For the last few weeks, just trying to ease my way back into the flow of things, the rhythm of our team. We've been playing well. Feel like we dropped some games we could have won, but I mean, we're in a good spot right now, and I didn't want to come in and step on anyone's toes. So my first game back, just wanted to get a good feel going up and down, see how my heel feels, and just work through the mental side of things, just being away from the game. And then also just balancing not being able to work on my game as much as I would like because of my heel, and not being able to put both my shoes on for like 10 days, 12 days, and, you know, not being able to put double socks on. You know, it's an adjustment once you have that type of injury. So it's my first time in my career I've had this type of injury, and it was unique. I wasn't sure how long I was going to be out. There was no structural damage done to it, but it was – achy and you get real I don't want to say humble, but you realize that the injury is a lot more significant when you can't get your other shoe on. So I'm appreciative of the hard work that our medical staff put in with me and my teammates trusting that I can be on the sideline and they can carry us. Yeah, feel good.
So now after the game, how do you feel?
Disappointed because I wanted to come back and get a win with my guys, but it was just one of those nights for us where we didn't start off the game very physical, and you can tell that this game had a little bit more energy for them. They definitely remembered the last time we played. They made adjustments. you know, and you can tell that they were playing with a different type of focus and mentality out there tonight, and they were forcing us to be stagnant offensively, which led to us not, you know, getting as many stops as we would have liked. So, you know, scored 34 points in the fourth quarter to our 11. You know, you're not going to win many NBA games playing that poorly. So we just take our licks and take our lessons and move forward.
What do you do when it feels stagnant, like you feel that your team's going half speed? What can you do to generate that energy?
By just reading the game at a different vantage point, different perspective. You know, I kind of figured the coach, Jazz, we're going to make some adjustments. Me and him have a good back and forth at times when we play against each other. So I was asking him, I think after the first quarter, like, how long are they going to play zone? And he just reminded us that, you know, Luka had a triple-double in the first half, and I had 15 of our you know, first 20 points or something like that last time we played. So they made adjustments. You got to give them credit. But when it gets stagnant on our end, we just got to be mature about how we approach it and continue to be very communicative and don't allow our offensive stagnation to dictate our defensive focus.
Physically, 32 or 3, whatever it was, did you feel okay coming out of this and the heal?
Yeah. It's a mental battle at this point, you know, having some time off. And you know, first time I got my the first foul that I got, Fontecchio came directly at my chest, and it just reminds you that this is a physical competitive game. You know, it's one thing playing pickup with the guys and, you know, kind of messing around, and it's a whole other thing when the game's on the line and somebody's coming at your chest. So I miss that, is what I'm saying. And you know, it snapped me right back into the physicality of the game, which I needed. So again, just continue to build reps and next man up mentality. You know, it's been our MO over this last month. We've had some unexpected injuries and, you know, things of that nature, but we can't make an excuse for ourselves. We're in the Western Conference, and teams are not going to take it easy on us. So.
Did the freak nature of the injury
scare me?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Because it came from nowhere.
I was scared, man. I was scared. I was very scared. My daughter was at the game. I was trying to, you know, make sure she was good first, so I went into daddy mode right after. But once I got home, man, it was a struggle. Just even going to sleep, and you could feel the throbbing, and you're just unsure. I was unsure of the significance of the injury and how long I was going to be out. And, you know, mentally, I started planning out my rehab, and the way to attack it is so unique, and you just really have to give it rest. And there's no real rest when you're at this point in the season. So the competitive spirit inside of me wants to get back on the court, but also the human side of me has to give my body time to heal, my mind time to heal, because it was a freak accident, it was. And any person that tells you that if they go through a freak accident, an injury, it doesn't bother them mentally, they're lying. You know, everybody saw it. It was one of those plays, could have gone either way. I could have fractured my ankle, I could have broken my ankle. So I'm just grateful, you know, and it wasn't Dwight's fault at all for how the play happened. You know, so I'm glad that we could move past that as a team, and now I'm back in the lineup and we could look forward to the future.
How helpful do you anticipate like a 7-game homestand as you continue to be able to like put in work after not being able to?
Oh, it's much needed. It's much needed. We've had a unique go to our season, and to be 19-15 at this point in the season, I'm happy about where we are. Not satisfied, and you know, we'll see what the next few days bring or the next few weeks bring as we get to play in front of our fans and we get to dial in and go to sleep in our own beds. And you know, it makes a big difference when you're an NBA player, when you can be home and you can lock into the goal at hand, which is to win every single game.
And Jason mentioned one area that could be improved is like the off-ball defensive like communication.
What
stood out to you? What could be like, I guess, improved heading into the homestand?
He's absolutely right. That was everything in his sentiment or his comment, just everything that he's.
Basically, I asked about it, and then he said the, you know, communication wasn't there, and you know, he to explain was a coach or whatever.
He didn't say any curse words or anything.
No, he did not.
Sorry. I mean, I wouldn't have been surprised. You know, the way our effort was tonight and our communication, it wasn't on the top tier level that we're used to, and we just got to recalibrate. You know, and we took our foot off the gas pedal a little bit tonight, and we definitely could have played better. I could have played better. And no, I've been out for a little while, but it's just still as a competitor, you want to come out with a win and play well for you guys.
Are you aware of the Jazz's triple-double drought, how long that was until tonight?
No, what was it?
Carlos Boozer, 2008.
Wow. Okay, so it was a big deal tonight. Shout out to Jay Clarkson. It's so fortunate that it happened against us, but anytime you get a triple-double in our league, it's a special night, especially coming off the bench. So happy for the guy, man. But, not again against us.
Thanks. You guys lacked energy tonight, and Utah hit you guys in the jaw. Why do you think that there was a lack of energy, if you agree with that?
They play great defense.
What made it? Were they switching it up a lot, or what did they do?
I mean, I think we should give credit to Jazz. You know, they played amazing defense today. Castle was down there covering the whole paint all the time. So, I think they made great adjustments to the game.
Did them switching up the defenses quite a bit? Does that bother you guys at all? Coach said you guys should have been ready for it, but you didn't execute.
I don't think they're switching up more, but I think in the second half they went to the zone all the time. So I think that was a big change for us. And like I said, you know, they played great zone the whole game.
How good was it to have Kyrie back out running with you?
I mean, great. You know, obviously we wanted to win, but, you know, first game back is always tough. I think everybody relaxed a little bit, you know, because we got Kai on the court. But, you know, obviously I'm very happy and everybody's happy that he's back. And now we got a big home stretch, so hopefully everybody's ready.
What are some focuses for the team that you think will be important for that 7-game homestand?
Just lock in, man. That's it.
You had whatever it is, 62 triple-doubles. The Jazz got one tonight from Jordan. It's been since 2008 since they've had a triple-double, anybody in the organization. Okay. Carlos Boozer, you may remember.
Yeah, I know who it is.
You know, surprising that any franchise goes that long without at least one.
I mean, I don't know. Yeah, that's a long time, you know. So I'm happy for them to celebrate. You know, that's a long time, and even they won, so they should be celebrating.
Thanks, guys.